Please stand. You shall cross the barren desert, but you shall not die of thirst. You shall wander far in safety, though you do not know the way. You shall speak your words in foreign lands, and all will understand. You shall see the face of God and live. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will. Blessed are the poor, for the kingdom shall be theirs. Blessed are you that weep and mourn, for one day you shall laugh. And if wicked men insult and hate you, all because of me. Blessed are you. Be not afraid. I go before you always. Come, follow me, and I will give you rest.
In the name of the Father, and of the Son, and of the Holy Spirit.
Amen.
The grace of our Lord Jesus Christ, the love of God, and the communion of the Holy Spirit be with you all.
And with your spirit.
Welcome to your friends. My name is Father Alexander Asirvadam, Assistant Pastor here at St. Thomas Becket. As we gather to pray for the soul of Raymond, I would like to extend my deepest sympathies to his children, Cindy, Stacy, and John, their spouses, his beloved brother Charles, his grandchildren, great-grandchildren, and other family members, friends, relatives present today, and those joining us remotely. Funeral provides the occasion for us to express our grief and our love as a community. Not only with our tears, but also with our words, music, our presence, at the same time as we pray for the soul of the deceased and those who survive here. Now, I invite Mr. Charles, the brother of Raymond, will say a few words of remembrance, followed by Raymond's daughter, Stacy. Please be seated.
Bonjour, mon nom c'est Charles, le frère de Raymond. The text that I'm about to read was prepared by Raymond's family, Giselle, Roland, and I. And it reminds us of the passage of Raymond on earth. C'est son histoire, c'est l'histoire de Raymond. Although Raymond spent the last 40 years in a medical institution since he suffered a stroke, in 1983, he's had an active life during his stay on Earth. Born in Dorchester, New Brunswick, in 1942, Raymond was diagnosed with a severe heart condition shortly after birth. At the age of 11, he went through heart surgery at the Boston Children's Hospital. His heart condition did not stop Raymond from being active, and he worked his way through life with success. Raymond was a happy child. He enjoyed telling stories and made friends wherever he went. En raison de sa situation cardiaque, Raymond n'était pas très porté vers l'espoir. Toutefois, nous nous rappellerons. Toutefois, nous nous rappellerons de la fois qu'il a organisé une partie de hockey dans la cuisine de ses parents, avec ses deux frères, Roland et moi. Et quel désarroi lorsque notre mère, de retour d'une réunion à l'église, constate que le plancher de la cuisine était plein de barres noires suite à la partie de hockey. Raymond et ses frères, croyant qu'ils étaient des Maurice et des Henri Richard en herbe. Raymond aimait la musique et s'adonnait à la batterie. Il frappait sur tout ce qu'il trouvait à frapper dessus pour s'accorder aux tunes d'Elvis Presley dont il ressemblait. Entre autres, nous pouvons encore entendre notre père lui dire « Raymond, arrête de frapper et fais donc tes devoirs. » Raymond worked in Quebec City, Baie-Comeau, and Montreal as a successful investigator with Equifax. In Baie-Comeau, Raymond was involved in charity organizations and became president of the Lions Club. He was proud of that, and he was well liked by members of the Lions organization and received marks of recognition for his work. Marié à Carole Crockett à Québec en 1963, le couple a eu quatre enfants, Cindy, John, Stacy et Eric. Raymond et Carole ont suivi les enseignements de leurs parents et les enfants furent élevés activement dans la communauté chrétienne. Membres de la paroisse Saint-Thomas à Beckett, ils en étaient de fidèles croyants. Entre autres, Raymond et sa fille Stacy étaient très engagés dans la chorale paroissiale. Raymond aimait la vie. Il manifestait partout où il s'arrêtait sa bonne humeur. On se rappellera des soupers de homard qu'il préparait pour ses amis, n'oubliant pas son petit verre de vin, et ses faces à répétition qu'il nous racontait sans cesse en riant aux éclats. En terminant, nous pouvons dire que Raymond a eu pendant sa vie sa part de malchance avec la maladie. Mais malgré tout, il a laissé une impression positive là où son parcours l'a amené. Nous n'oublierons jamais son rire et sa bonne humeur, et en nous disant à chaque fois qu'on le voyait et qu'on disait « Comment ça va, Raymond? » Et Raymond de répondre « Pour y aller, ça va. C'est pour revenir que c'est compliqué. » Sur ce, bye Raymond et bon voyage.
Hello, everybody. I would like to thank you all for coming, and a special thank you to those of you who have traveled a long distance to be here today. From the time I was a little girl, I always looked up to my daddy. Throughout my life, he has always been my hero, my strength, my courage, my number one dad. He was a man of great faith. His faith is what kept him alive for so long. He raised his children with faith. And if it wasn't for him, I wouldn't be where I am today. I owe everything to him. For giving me that very special gift called faith. I have such fond memories of he and I listening to the radio in the car on the way to the rectory for choir practice every Thursday night as he tapped his fingers on the steering wheel and played the bongos on the dashboard. He and I sang together during Sunday Mass on this very choir loft. his faith, his love for his children, his love of music, and his resilience is the perfect definition of my father, Raymond. After his stroke, when he was settled into his residence at Grace Dart, as soon as he could, he was attending Mass every Sunday and proudly volunteering to do the readings. He was also a member of the social committee, joined the choir, participated in group activities such as bowling, apple picking, bingo, holiday events, and the all-you-can-eat buffet at Vigie's. My father loved food, and with good reason, as it was his only pleasure in life. I took such joy in bringing him lobster and seeing him enjoy it the way he did. I know I don't only speak for myself when I say I have great memories of eating lobster with him. For many years, my father worked so hard doing his best to recover from his stroke by going to physiotherapy every day. He showed such perseverance, strength, and determination to reach his goal to walk again. And walk again he did. The first and only time in my life I saw my father proudly and courageously walk his daughter, my sister Cindy, down this very aisle to this very altar. I'll never forget the time my ex-fiancé and I broke up in 2012. My Aunt Suzanne and Uncle Roland drove here from Fredericton to be with me, to comfort and console me. The next day, we went to visit my father, and for the first time in my life, he hugged me so tight in a way I've never been hugged by him before. Sorry. He knew how sad and broken I was, and in that moment, I knew he could feel the pain I felt. Thank you so much, Daddy, for staying with me for all these years, for loving me and supporting me. I will miss you every day of my life. You are now with Mommy and Eric in heaven. Please keep them close to you until I see you again one sweet day. Rest in peace, Daddy. I will always love you.
Let us stand. In baptism, Raymond was given a share in the death and resurrection of Christ. We commend him to the mercy of God and surrender him with the church prayer, may we all feast at the heavenly banquet. Brothers and sisters, let us acknowledge our sins and failures and so prepare the celebrated sacred mysteries in a worthy manner. I confess to Almighty God and to my brothers and sisters that I have greatly sinned, my thoughts, my words, in what I have done and what I have failed to do. To my most grievous fall, therefore I ask Blessed Mary, a Virgin, all the angels and saints, and to my brothers to pray for me, Lord our God. May Almighty God have mercy on us, forgive us our sins, and bring us to everlasting life.
Amen.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Christ have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Lord have mercy.
Let us pray. O God, whose nature is always to forgive and show mercy, we humbly implore you for your servant Raymond, whom you have called this day to journey to you. And since he hoped and believed in you, grant that he may be led to our true homeland to delight in its everlasting joy. Through our Lord Jesus Christ, your Son, who lives and reigns with you in the unity of the Holy Spirit, God forever and ever. Amen. Amen. Let us sit and listen for the gospel reading, scripture reading.
A reading from the book of the prophet Isaiah. On this mountain, the Lord of hosts will make for all peoples a feast of rich food. And he will destroy on this mountain the shroud that is cast over all peoples, the sheet that is spread over all nations. He will swallow up death forever. Then the Lord God will wipe away the tears from all faces and the disgrace of his people. He will take away from all the earth, for the Lord has spoken. It will be said on that day, "See, this is our God. We have waited for him so that he might save us. This is the Lord for whom we have waited. Let us be glad and rejoice in his salvation." The word of the Lord.
My shepherd is the Lord, nothing indeed shall I want. The Lord is my shepherd, I shall not want. He makes me lie down in green pastures. He leads me beside still waters. He restores my soul. My shepherd is the Lord, nothing indeed shall I want. He leads me in right paths for his name's sake. Even though I walk through the darkest valley, I fear no evil. For you are with me. Your rod and your staff, they comfort me. My shepherd is the Lord, nothing indeed shall I want. You prepare a table before me in the presence of my enemies. You anoint my head with oil. My cup overflows. My shepherd is the Lord, nothing indeed shall I want. Surely goodness and mercy shall follow me all the days of my life, and I shall dwell in the house of the Lord my whole life long. My shepherd is the Lord, nothing indeed shall I want.
A reading from the letter of St. Paul to the Romans. Brothers and sisters, do you not know that all of us who have been baptized into Christ Jesus were baptized into his death? Therefore, we have been buried with him by baptism into death, so that just as Christ was raised from the dead by the glory of the Father, so we too might walk in newness of life. For if we have been united with him in death like this, we will certainly be united with him in the resurrection like this. We know that our old self was crucified with him so that the body of sin might be destroyed and we might no longer be enslaved to sin. For whoever has died is freed from sin. But if we have died with Christ, we believe that we will also live with him. We know that Christ, being raised from the dead, will never die again. Death no longer has dominion over him. The word of the Lord.
Thanks be to God.
Please stand.
Praise to you, Lord, King of eternal glory. I am the resurrection and the life, says the Lord. Whoever believes in me will not die forever. Praise to you, Lord, King of eternal glory.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
A reading from the Holy Gospel according to John.
Glory to you, Lord.
Jesus said to his disciples, "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Believe in God, believe also in me. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places. If it were not so, would I have told you that I go to prepare a place for you? And if I go and prepare a place for you, I will come again and will take you to myself, so that where I am, there you may be also. And you know the way to the place where I am going." Thomas said to him, "Lord, we do not know where you are going. How can we know the way?" Jesus said to him, "I am the way and the truth and the life. No one comes to the Father except through me." The Gospel of the Lord.
Praise to you, Lord Jesus Christ.
Please be seated. Dear brothers and sisters, once again, on behalf of the Paris community, I would like to extend our sincere condolences and sympathy to the members of Raymond's family, especially to his children Cindy, Stacy, and John, and his beloved brother Charles, grandchildren, great-grandchildren, and to all the extended family and friends. I would like to assure you of our continued remembrance of Raymond in our thoughts, prayers, masses, in the days, weeks, months, and even the year ahead. Whenever we lose a person dear to us, a person who has played a significant role in our lives, we are flooded with all types of emotions. The first emotion we experience is sadness. Someone we love is no longer present with us. And no matter what we do, we cannot change the fact. We might also feel angry at God for having taken him from us. We may wonder why God has done this to us. All these emotions are normal and part of our grieving process. But as a Catholic, we believe that their life is changed, not ended, is now with Jesus. A few days back, when I talked to his daughters, Stacy and Cindy, I understood that Raymond is a man of faith and prayer. He professed and witnessed the faith not only with himself, but also with his beloved children and friends. He always loved to go to the church. He had a great reverence for the Holy Communion. In his earthly life, he always praised God through his music and singing. Now he is in the arms of Jesus. Our reading from the scripture gives us a great consolation. In our first reading, we were told that the Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek. Isaiah chapter 25, verse 6 to 9. Then people will say, "This is our Lord, in whom we hoped for salvation. The Lord is the one in whom we hoped." That line from scripture describes us also. We hope in the Lord for salvation.
We know that nothing or nobody in this life can save us. We know that we cannot take even $1 to heaven. We know that everything we do makes sense only if it is leading us to peace in God. We know there are many distractions and temptations in life, all pretending to offer us peace and happiness. But none of them do, because we know that we will find this peace and happiness only in God. When we find our peace in God, when we become friends of God, when we live with God's love in our hearts, then we have peace. That is really true in the life of Raymond. That is why our first reading said, "The Lord will wipe away the tears from every cheek." When we hope in the Lord for salvation, how blessed we are. We will still have problems, but the Lord is there to wipe away the tears from every eyes. When we hope in Him and have His love in our hearts. Near the end of Jesus' life on earth, He spoke to His disciples these very comforting words from the gospel just to be heard. "Do not let your hearts be troubled. Have faith in God and have faith in me also. In my Father's house there are many dwelling places." Many of us work hard in life to build a house and make a home for ourselves and for our families. But no matter how hard and we work, no matter how large or small our houses, those structures are never our permanent homes. The structures we build to live in are only temporary dwelling places. Death reminds us of this. Death reminds us that there is no final resting place in this world. Even the grave is a temporary. We are always being in between this life and the life to come. While we are truly saddened over the passing from this life of Raymond, our faith reassures that the sadness that we are now experiencing will in time be not just changed, but transformed into joy. Because Raymond, like Jesus, has died. But he has died into resurrection. Even now, as we continue to celebrate his funeral liturgy, he is enjoying the fullness of God's presence and will continue to enjoy the fullness forever. There is a wonderful poem by David Harkins. It reads, "Remember me to the living, I am gone. To the sorrowful, I will never return. To the angry, I was cheated. But to the happy, I am at peace. And to the faithful, I have never left. I cannot speak, but I can listen. I cannot be seen, but I can be heard. So as you stand upon a chair gazing at the beautiful sea, as you look upon the flower and admire its simplicity, remember me. Remember me in your heart, your thoughts and your memories of the times we loved, the times we cried, the times we fought, the times we laughed. For if you always think of me, I will never have gone." As we thank God for Raymond's life and for his calling in Christian life, let us place him in the hands of our Blessed Mother. She understands our pain and suffering. May she intercede for him. May our Lord grant him eternal rest in his heavenly kingdom. May his soul rest in peace. Amen.
Let us stand. Prayer of faithful. God, the Almighty Father, raised Christ, his Son, from the dead. With confidence, we ask him to save his people, living and dead.
For Raymond, who in baptism was given the pledge of eternal life, that he may now be admitted to the company of the saints, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our brother who ate the body of Christ, the bread of life, that he may be raised up on the last day, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For our deceased relatives and friends, and for all who have helped us, that they may have the reward of their goodness. And we remember especially Raymond's wife, Carol, his son, Eric, his parents, Antoine and Doris, and his sister, Helena. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For those who have fallen asleep, in the hope of rising again, that they may see God face to face, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For the family and friends of our brother Raymond, that they may be consoled in their grief by the Lord, who wept at the death of his friend Lazarus, let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer.
For all of us assembled here, to worship in faith that we may be gathered together again in God's kingdom. Let us pray to the Lord.
Lord, hear our prayer. God, our shelter and our strength, listen in love to the prayer of your people. Hear the prayers we offer for our departed brothers and sisters. Cleanse them of their sins and grant them the fullness of redemption through Christ our Lord. Amen. Amen. Please be seated.
Amazing grace, how sweet the sound that saved a wretch like me. I once was lost, but now am found, was blind, but now I see. 'Twas grace that taught my heart to fear, and grace my fears relieved. How precious did that grace appear, the hour I first believed. The Lord has promised good to me, his word, my hope secures. He will my shield and portion be, as long as life endures.
Pray, brothers and sisters, that my sacrifice and yours may be accepted to God, the Almighty Father.
May the Lord accept the sacrifice at your hands
for the praise and glory of his name,
for our good and the good of all his holy church.
Almighty and merciful God, by means of this sacrificial offering, wash away, we pray, the blood of Christ, the sins of a departed servant, Raymond, and purify unceasingly by your merciful forgiveness,
those he once cleansed in the waters of baptism, through Christ our Lord.
Amen.
The Lord be with you.
And with your spirit.
Lift up your hearts.
We lift them up to the Lord.
Let us give thanks to the Lord our God.
It is right and just.
It is truly right and just, our duty and our salvation, always and everywhere to give you thanks. Lord, Holy Father, Almighty and Eternal God, through Christ our Lord. For as one alone he accepted death, so that we might all escape from dying, as one man he chose to die, so that in his sight we all might live forever. And so in company with the choirs of the angels, we praise you and with joy we proclaim.
Holy, holy, holy Lord. Holy, holy, holy Lord, God of hosts, heaven and earth are full of your glory. Hosanna, Hosanna in the highest. Blessed is he who comes in the name of the Lord. Hosanna in the highest.
Kneel down. You are indeed holy, O Lord, the fount of all holiness. Make holy, therefore, these gifts, we pray, by sending down your Spirit upon the like dewfall, so that they may become for us the body and blood of our Lord Jesus Christ. At the time he was betrayed and ended in his passion, he took bread and, giving thanks, broke it, gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and eat of it, for this is my body, which will be given up for you." In a similar way, when supper was ended, he took the chalice and, once more giving thanks, he gave it to the disciples, saying, "Take this, all of you, and drink from it, for this is the chalice of my blood, the blood of the new and eternal covenant, which will be poured out for you and for many for the forgiveness of sins. Do this in memory of me." The mystery of faith.
When we eat this bread and drink this cup, we proclaim your death, O Lord, until you come again.
Therefore, as we celebrate the memorial of his death and resurrection, we offer you, Lord, the bread of life, the chalice of salvation, giving thanks that you have held us worthy to be in your presence and minister to you. Humbly we pray that, partaking of the body and blood of Christ, we may be gathered into one by the Holy Spirit. Remember, Lord, your church spread throughout the world, and bring her to the fullness of charity, together with Francis, our Pope, and Christian, our Bishop, and all the clergy. Remember your servant, Raymond, who we have called today from this world to yourself. Grant that he who was united with your son in death like this, like his, may also be one with him in his resurrection. Remember also our brothers and sisters who have fallen asleep in the hope of the resurrection. And all who have died in your mercy, welcome them in the light of your face. Have mercy on us all, we pray, that with the Blessed Virgin Mary, Mother of God, with the Blessed Joseph, her spouse, with the Blessed Apostles and all the saints who have pleased you throughout the ages, we may merit to be coheirs to eternal life, and may praise and glorify you through our Son, Jesus Christ. Through him and with him in him, O God Almighty Father, in the unity of the Holy Spirit, all glory and honor is yours,
forever and ever.
Amen. Amen. Amen.
At the Savior command and from the divine teaching, we dare to say,
Our Father,
who art in heaven, hallowed be thy name. Thy kingdom come, thy will be done, on earth as it is in heaven. Give us this day our daily bread, and forgive us our trespasses, as we forgive those trespass against us. And lead us not temptation, but deliver us from evil. Deliver us, Lord, we pray, from every evil. Graciously grant peace in our days, that by the help of your mercy, we may be always free from sin and safe from all distress. As we await the blessed hope and the coming of our Savior, Jesus Christ.
For the kingdom, the power, and the glory are yours, now and forever.
Lord Jesus Christ, who said to apostles, Peace I leave you, my peace I give you. Look not on our sins, but on the faith of your church, and graciously grant her peace and unity in accordance with your will, who live and reign forever and ever.
Amen.
The peace of the Lord be with you always.
And with your spirit.
Let us offer each other a sign of peace.
Lamb of God, you take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us, Lamb of God. You take away the sins of the world. Have mercy on us, Lamb of God. You take away the sins of the world. Grant us peace.
Behold the Lamb of God, behold him who takes away the sins of the world. Blessed are those called to the supper of the Lamb.
Lord, I am not worthy that you should enter under my roof, but only say the word, and my soul shall be healed. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there is hatred, let me bring your love. Where there is injury, your pardon, Lord. And where there's doubt, true faith in you. Make me a channel of your peace. Where there's despair in life, let me bring hope. Where there is darkness, only light. And where there's sadness, ever joy. O Master, grant that I may never seek so much to be consoled as to console. To be understood as to understand, to be loved as to love with all my soul. Make me a channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving to all men that we receive, and in dying that we're born to eternal life. Channel of your peace. It is in pardoning that we are pardoned, in giving to all men that we receive, and in dying that we're born to eternal life.
Let us pray. Lord God, whose Son left us the sacrament of his body, food for the journey, mercifully grant that, strengthened by it, our brother Raymond may come to the eternal table of Christ, who lives and reigns forever and ever. Amen. Confident in our hope of eternal life, let us commend him to the loving mercy of our Father. Let our prayers go with him. He was adopted as God's children in baptism and was nourished at the table of the Lord. May he now inherit the promise of eternal life and take his place at the table of God's children in heaven. Let us pray also on our own behalf that we who now mourn or saddened, may one day go forth with our brother to meet the Lord of life when he appears in glory. In baptism, Raymond shared in the death and resurrection of Christ. May he be welcomed into the glory of eternal life. As a sign of respect for our brother Raymond, we let this incense rise to God, who has called him to share in his glory.
Songs of the angels welcome you and guide you along your way. May the smiles of the martyrs greet your home as darkness turns into day. Every fear will be undone and death will be no more. As songs of the angels bring you home before the face of God. Every fear will be undone and death will be no more. As songs of the angels bring you home before the face of of God.
Into our hands, Father of mercies, we command our brother Raymond, the sure and certain hope, that together with all who have died with Christ, he will rise with him on the last day. We give you thanks for the blessing which you bestowed upon Raymond in this life. They are signs to us of our goodness and of our fellowship with the saints in Christ. Merciful Lord, turn toward us and listen to our prayers. Open the gates of paradise to a servant and help us who remain to comfort one another with the assurance of faith until we all meet in Christ and are with you and with our brother forever. Amen. Dear friends, may every mark of the affection and every gesture of friendship that you give to others be a sign of God's peace for you. In peace and in the sure hope of the resurrection, we take leave of the remains of our brother, knowing that one day we shall be with him in heaven. Amen.
My God, when I in awesome wonder consider all the worlds thy hands have made, I see the stars, I hear the rolling thunder, thy power throughout the universe displayed. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. And sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. When Christ shall come, with shouts of acclamation, and take me home, what joy shall fill my heart. Then I shall bow in humble adoration, and there proclaim, my God, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art, how great thou art. Then sings my soul, my Savior God, to thee, how great thou art.